We want to thank Google's Science Journal app for supporting PBS Digital Studios.
Describe what's happening.
Oh, it's good. The world is spinning around in a circle.
Okay, if you spin around, you get dizzy. That's not exactly rocket science. We've all been there. But you can hijack your senses, like we just did, and get what I'm gonna call weird dizzy. And it can teach us how our bodies know where they are in space. Hey, smart people, Joe here. How do you know when your body is moving? Well, for most of us, the answer is right here. We can see ourselves moving. But what if you're blindfolded?
I think we're just moving straight. Well, that was a left and then a right.
You have a special sense that tells you whether your body is moving and how your body is oriented in three dimensions. It's called your vestibular sense. And if you spin around in circles, you can break it. But it turns out you can break your vestibular sense system in a few different ways if you change how you get dizzy. Now we're gonna do a little experiment to see if maybe we can decode how this vestibular sense works. Of course, I'm not gonna get dizzy. I'm gonna make my friend Vanessa Hill from BrainCrat do it. I mean, every experiment needs a control group, right?
Hello, hello.
Hi, it's great to be here.
Yeah, I'm kind of excited.
When you were a kid, did you ever sit down in an office chair and like spin yourself around as fast as you could?
Definitely.
Okay, have you ever done it when you were an adult?
No.
You're sitting in an office chair. Surprise, are you ready?
I guess so.
She's not ready. How do you feel?
Okay, everything's moving back and forth like this.
Horizontally.
Like horizontally.
Okay, so that's normal dizzy. Most of us have felt that, not too bad. Well, watch this.
We're gonna do this again, but this time we're gonna hold your head in a different position.
Okay.
Keeping your head, you know, eyeballs down 90 degrees, or you can look straight up.
So if I throw up, it will either be back on my face or just on my lap.
Probably safer to throw up down.
Okay, I'm gonna do that then. It's good, the world is spinning around in a circle. But it was like on an arc, it was like everything was going up and down.
This time.
What other way is there?
You're going like to hold your head to the side so that your ear is facing the floor. You ready?
I suppose.
I'm ready.
Oh my god! Oh, that is horrible! The whole world is just moving up and down. Okay, so there's a light right here. So the light was like moving like this, just continually up and down.
Okay, so what the heck is going on? Well, your vestibular system is located in your inner ear. It has two important parts, the semicircular canals and the otoliths. Otolith means ear stone. They're literally little chunks of calcium carbonate suspended inside your head. Basically, every vertebrate has them, from fish to birds to mammals, and they're how we sense gravity and know which way is up or down. For our dizzy experiment, though, we're interested in a rotational motion, not linear motion. And rotational motion is sensed by the semicircular canals. The semicircular canals are tubes in the shape of half circles, and inside they're filled with fluid. There are three semicircular canals in each inner ear, three on the left and three on the right for six total. Having three canals on each side allows your body to sense motion in three dimensions, along three planes at perpendicular angles to each other. The superior canal detects movement along the x-axis. The lateral canal detects movement along the y-axis. And the posterior canal detects movement on the z-axis. Your inner ears are basically like the inertial guidance system in an airplane, which tells the pilot about the plane's pitch, yaw, and roll. But how do they do that? Well, they use physics. Doesn't everything. Specifically, they use inertia, an object's resistance to a change in its motion. Now, when your skull moves, the liquid in your semicircular canal doesn't move immediately with it. It sloshes around inside its tube. The semicircular canals have these special cells that sense motion called hair cells. The inertia sloshing bends the hair cells, and bending causes a change in the signals fired to the brain. Now, the hair cells are actually firing all the time, even when you're sitting still, but bending in one direction increases the rate of firing, and bending in the other direction decreases the rate of firing. Now, each pair of canals, right and left, work together, and your brain adds up their signals in a way that not only says your head is moving, but it tells you in which direction. Now, Vanessa held her head in different axes, X, Y, and Z, while she was spinning, which sloshed the liquid in each of her three semicircular canals, one for each axis of motion, which gave three different sensations of dizziness. Did you notice when Vanessa said the room looked like it was spinning? You've probably experienced that when you were dizzy too. Well, the room wasn't spinning, I checked. Now, I had her hold a camera up to her eyes right as she stopped moving. Watch what happened. When you get dizzy, your eyes respond by jumping back and forth involuntarily. It's called nystagmus. If you look very closely, you'll see that Vanessa's eye movements are actually faster in one direction and slower in the other. And normally, if you move your head with your eyes open, a reflex called the vestibulo-ocular response moves your eyes in the opposite direction of your head's motion in order to keep your eyes on target. Have you ever watched a dancer spin and notice how they spot on something and move their head and eyes opposite of the spin? It's like that. And when you stop spinning suddenly, your eye keeps twitching in the opposite direction of the spin. It's a reflex. The reason the room looks like it's spinning when you stop is because your eye movements are making it spin. When Vanessa held her head in different positions, the room seemed to spin in different directions because her vestibulo-ocular response reacted in three different ways. So how do figure skaters, pilots, or skater boys not get dizzy if they're doing so much spinning? Well, they do a lot of practice, and their bodies adapt. For most feelings or sensations that our bodies experience, when they're repeated and repeated, the body's response gets weaker. It sort of tunes down the volume. You've probably experienced this when getting into cold or hot water. I mean, at first, your body really senses it, but that response gets weaker as our brain tunes it down. Even though you're still feeling the cold or the heat, it becomes your new normal. If we consciously felt everything that we're feeling all the time, it would be total sensory overload. When figure skaters, pilots, or skater boys practice spinning over and over, their short-term dizziness response gets weaker and weaker. Because we evolved on Earth, these vestibular senses rely a lot on gravity. Now, up in a microgravity environment like the space station, astronauts and their inner ears are constantly falling together all the time. So an astronaut's vestibular system adapts to this new normal after just a few days up there.
So I wanted to do a quick check today and just to see if I can make myself dizzy.
It's not making me feel ill at all, not in the slightest, not dizzy.
Down here on Earth, some people's vestibular systems don't work the right way, and they can give sensations of movement or falling even when that's not happening. That's called vertigo. It can make life pretty uncomfortable. If you want to try this at home, it's super fun. You should. Just make sure to do it with a friend, or to a friend, and wear a helmet. Oh wait, we didn't wear a helmet, did we? And you know that funny feeling in your head right now? That's called learning. It could be dizziness too. Stay curious. That was really fun. A big thanks to Vanessa. Make sure that you head over to BrainCrat and watch her video. Sure, I got her really dizzy, but she got a lot of other people really dizzy, and it's hilarious, but it was for science. Hey guys, a big thanks to Google for supporting PBS Digital Studios. Their mobile app, Science Journal, lets you take notes and measure scientific phenomena like light and sound and motion using your phone or your tablet or your Chromebook. You can find activity ideas and additional information on their website at g.co/sciencejournal, or just click on the link down in the description below.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
I meant to do that. That was on purpose. Definitely hit it feeling the arc thing. Where'd you go? Where are you?
I'm here. Okay. I'm here. It's okay.